So yesterday we completed pond as a habitat. I gave you a few questions. Did you answer them? I asked you to write in the classwork, and it is a very, very important answer for 8 marks. So once again, don't waste the time. Revise that pond as a habitat. Today we are going with the tree as a habitat. Today what is our topic? Tree as a habitat. So see here. So when we are taking a tree as a habitat, what are the different places it is having? The first one is base of the tree. The first one is base of the tree. Second one is the trunk of the tree. The third one is middle of the branches. Okay, next fourth one, on the leaves. These are the different places for the trees. The trees where few living organisms survive their life. Did you observe anytime a big tree near to your house? If you have a big tree near to your house, I am ready to give you a small homework. Start from today itself. For weekdays, try to observe that particular tree. Means, for suppose today you are observing the tree, select a big large tree and a huge branches, leaves, everything will be there that you select, and daily a particular time. Today you started at 8 o'clock to observe that one, tomorrow also. Like that, 4 to 5 days, try to observe that particular tree. And see how many living organisms, how many creatures are there on that particular tree. Means not only between the branches or on the leaves, from the base to the top of the tree, you have to observe, and this is a homework. You have to. I will explain for you at the base of the tree what will be there, trunk of the tree, middle of the branches, and on the leaves what will be there. I will explain for you. I'm not asking that. Near to your house, what you observed, I want that. Okay. Why? Because on a few trees we can find different types of. See, early morning, you just get up at 4-5 o'clock or 5-6 o'clock, you try to observe. Number of different varieties of birds will be present on you. When early hours you are saying crows and monkeys may be there on the trees, but early morning you try to observe different varieties of birds will be present on the trees. If we see them, we like to hold them. We want to keep in our small cage, we have to, in that we have to keep that one. Or we like to keep in our house, or we like to take pics. Nowadays, the phone is ready in our hand. Whatever is interesting, we are ready to click it. Is it correct or not? Like that, different colors, yellow, green, blue, pink. In different colors, we can see different varieties of birds on the trees. So, daily for 4 days, try to observe. The same varieties of birds are there, or the same varieties of animals are there, the same variety of creatures are there for the 4 days. Or for every day, did you find any change on the trees? Okay? Or what did you notice? These all things you have to tell for me. So, coming to here, we can see tree as a habitat, base of the tree, trunk of the tree, middle of the branches, and on the leaves. Base of the tree. What we can find there? Here we can see that the roots will be penetrated at the base of the tree. The roots will be very, very strong, and the roots will penetrate out into the soil. On these roots and to the base, we can see the algae will be present. What is this algae? The green colored substance. the green color velvet substance will be presented. Why it will be present here? You can see that when it is raining, because of the stagnated water near to the roots and the base of the tree, you can see that that particular place will be with the algae, the green velvet color substance. Telugulo paakudu, we will say that such a type of thing was algae. Next one was, you can see mushrooms, you will know, these are not mushrooms. It looks like mushrooms at the base of the tree. These are called as saprophytes. Saprophytes means from the dead and decaying parts of plants and animals. You can see here, these look like mushrooms. But as I said that these look like mushrooms, you don't pluck them and eat it. It is very poisonous. Just a microorganism, through microorganism it is formed. These are called as a saprophyte. What we can see, the roots penetrates, the algae will be present here. And you can see the saprophytes are here. Not only this, you can see here the snakes. You can see here snakes. Earthworms, you can see snakes, earthworms, etc. will be present here. Did you understand? Algae at the base of the tree, what will be there? Algae will be present. The shape of mushroom type of saprophytes will be here. Snakes will be there, earthworms will be there, ants will be present. Okay, these are the few things you can find at the base of them. Now, trunk of the tree. Here you can see the trunk is made, it is full of like this cracked wood will be present here. Okay, between, if I am ready to take the bark of the tree, here you can see some ants will be there. Okay, some ants will be there. And next one is here you can see woodworms, we will say. What we will say? Woodworms. Ants will be there. Woodworms will be present. Okay. Small insects will be present. And gum-like substance also will be here. Means the excretory. Now, how human beings and animals will release the excretory? Even plants also will release the excretory. That excretory, it will be coming out near the trunk part of the tree, that is in a gummy like substance. It is not waste. We will use that to prepare rubber. Okay. We will use to prepare, what is a gum? These all we will use. We will say this as resins. So here this part. Did you understand what will be there near to the trunk of the tree? Next, coming to the middle of the branches. In the middle of the branches, you can see what will be present, crows. Okay, next you can see bats. At night time, did you observe any time at the night time, you can see lot of bats will be on huge trees. Morning hours, you can't find them. Only, we told that nocturnals. When I told you about the, what do animals eat at that particular time, I told nocturnals. Nocturnals means what? Which search their food at night are called as nocturnals. That are the bats. Not only bats, owl. Okay? Then squirrels. All, I won't mention one bird for you. Why? Because the sparrows, the pigeons, crows, okay, bats, owls, squirrels, these all will be in the middle of the branches. Okay, not only this, the very, very important thing, how you will be, this also will be like that, means monkeys. We can see that they will do nonsense, jumping from one branch to another branch, okay, moving from here to there, you can sit now in the class properly. You will move from this place to that place to this place in the same way. The monkeys also on the branches, they will hold the branches, they will swing like this or jump from one branch to another. They will shake the trees and do all the nonsense. And this is the habitat for monkeys also, which is the habitat, the big trees. So at the middle of the branches, you can see crows, bats, owls, squirrels and the monkeys. Then, now base was completed, trunk of the tree was completed, then middle of the branches was completed on the leaves. On the leaves, already we discussed what will be there, eggs. Eggs means, you know, the small insects like the caterpillars or worms. There will be, you can see that there will be bottom. If you take bottom of the leaf, here the caterpillars will be present and green color or white color worms will be present. What they will do? They will secrete the saliva outside from this and under. So suppose this is a leaf, you can see here. On this, these caterpillars will be there. Did you understand? And they will form the cocoons around it. What they will form? Cocoon around itself. Not only cocoons, when you see on the leaf, here you can see small white color. Means, with naked eye, you can see very small. When you are observing under a microscope, you can see they will be very large. These are the eggs of some worms. Okay? On the leaves, what we can see? On the leaves, we can see cocoons. We can see eggs and also the caterpillars will be present on the leaves. And very important thing I forgot to say here, in the middle of the branches, two are there. What are those, you know? The birds will form nests to lay the eggs. The birds will form a nest here. For what purpose? To lay the eggs. And not only this, another one more is there. What is that? Here I mentioned honeybee nest. Honeybee will also form its, the honeybee's nest will be in the middle of the branches. So tree as a habitat, this is called as a terrestrial habitat. Which is very important. What are the different places of the tree? The base of the tree, trunk of the tree, then branches, middle branches of the tree, and on the leaves. What are the different organisms are found? I hope you understood. And what is the name for tree as a habitat? It is a terrestrial habitat. And as I gave you the homework, from today you start. You select any hour, any time. It may be 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, early morning, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock. That is up to you. 4 days, a particular time you select. And in that particular time, in the 4 days, what are the different creatures you are finding on that particular tree? Here, I gave only few examples for you. Did you understand it? Only few examples are given for you, but you try to analyze. Still, you think and near to your house, what I discussed and is more, what are the different types of creatures and animals you can find. You try to mention that in your classwork. When the school opens, I will check that one. And few of the questions are given for you on this terrestrial habitat in your textbook. For that particular questions, you have to answer which type of animals you are seeing, which type of birds you are seeing, and which types of worms you are seeing. What are the creatures which are living on this? If the very important thing, we should, after seeing all these things, you try to understand it. If I am going to cut this particular tree, suppose imagine this tree is near to my house. These many creatures are living on this particular tree. Daily I am enjoying to see this one. But and even I am getting a fresh shade and a shade under this tree. Not only me, these many creatures are living. One day I got angry and I just means I don't want the tree with the huge monkeys are coming. So because of that I cut the tree. What will happen? I disturbed the habitat of these many creatures. Their livelihood is disturbed, no? Where they will go now? So, please don't destroy or disturb the habitat of these creatures which are surviving their life on this tree. Tomorrow we will discuss a house as a habitat. Thank you.